I have to stress again the saying, the more the better. There is one case where it is not really true. On every lens surface, you have a reflection rate of about 4 to 5%. So that means for a complete lens element, front side and back side, you have reflections up to 8 to 10%. That means 10% of the light is gone. But fortunately, there was a solution for this problem. It was known that modified optical surfaces can reduce these reflections, but there was no industrial process to do this modification. And it was in 1935 when Alexander Smakula, a ZEISS scientist, invented a process to apply thin coating layers on optics. And by applying these thin layers on the optics, it is possible to reduce the reflections dramatically. This was the birth of the T-Star brand. T was at the beginning, later on it was called T-Star, because this technology of applying thin layers was not developed and finished. It is an ongoing process. And after several years, there was an improvement by applying several layers, and then it was called T-Star. And this development is going on and on until today. Today we have coating layers that can reduce reflections to 0.1, 0.2%, which means a lot of light coming to the sensor and also having very, very few reflections in the image. So this was a very quick run through history. But what are we doing actually? Let me start at the very beginning. The foundation for quality of a modern camera system is laid long before the hardware is built. And to develop and build a modern camera system, you need a network of partners. To create this network of partners, you have to qualify them. Do you have to assess them? Do you have to assess the production capabilities, the quality assurance, the quality management system, which is a very core factor. Having a good running management system, and based on these assessments, to qualify the partners where necessary, to establish processes, joint processes that work seamlessly together. And after having these principles set up, then we have to go to the individual development of a device. We also have to start without building the hardware. We have to start much earlier. We have to define a specification of the camera system. We have to define quality limits. And also we have create an optical design, which means the structure of the optics of these camera systems. And all this is done based on simulations. So let me start with the optical design of a lens. The optical design defines the structure of the lens and the properties of this lens. And some major properties I want to name are the contrast function, the shading, the distortion, and the chromatic aberration, which results in color fringes. These various parameters of the optical design usually are columns of numbers or graphs that are not self-explaining. Experts can, to a certain extent, analyze these graphs and have a glimpse idea if it's good or bad. But with the help of simulation tools, we can make the close the gap between the graphs and the real image. So we can, for example, for the contrast function, for the contrast of the image, we can simulate real images and see how this contrast curve corresponds to the image quality. And then it's very easy to say, well, this image quality is good enough of the lens, or we need to improve it and have another development cycle before building anything. And it's a similar thing with chromatic aberration. Let me briefly explain what chromatic aberration means. So everybody of you knows the rainbow colors. That is because the light consists of colors ranging from red to blue. By having a prism, you can split these colors and you see no longer the white light, but the colors. And a lens is nothing but an endless number of prisms put together. And therefore, also a lens produces these rainbow colors. That is something you cannot avoid. You have heard earlier with the gauze doublets, there is a possibility to reduce that. And to know if the reduction of this color fringes is good enough, we also have a simulation that shows how strong these color fringes will be visible in the actual image. In this example, you have a real image where you can see these color fringes. The foreground shows purplish color, the background showing greenish colors. So this was about optical design and its analysis. And let me now come to T-star and reflections. There are many names for these effects and artifacts in the images. It's called flare, it's ghost, it's wheeling glare, and whatever. But in the image, what you see are circular artifacts, reflections, or these petal flares coming from the sensor surface. All of this is more or less disturbing. Sometimes you want reflexes like that because you have learned that reflexes belong to an image. But in most cases, they are really, really unwanted. And this is where it comes into the game that we are using the T-star coatings to reduce them to a minimum. But what does it mean, reducing to a minimum? There we need to get a feeling. Are the coatings that we apply good enough? And it's not just the coatings, it's also the mechanical surface. Is the reflection reduction of these mechanical surfaces good enough? Earlier in this video, I was also talking of T-star, the reflection reduction. So on the images here, you see some very typical flares and ghosts that you can see in images. You have radial structures, you have reflections, and you have this very typical petal flare that is caused by the sensor. These are not completely defined by the optical design. Partially, yes, but mostly by the coatings and surfaces of the lenses and the mechanical components. And also for this, we have developed a simulation tool. A simulation tool that can simulate the complete lens, including the coatings, including the mechanical components, and therefore we call it, it's a digital twin, because all components of the camera are virtually existing in the digital world. And we can send light rays through the camera system at any stage, and then we can see every reflection in the image. And here in this example, you can see very good on these images, the comparison of a real lens and the simulated image of it. And it's amazing how precise all the reflections, all the flare is visible already in the simulation. After looking at this theoretical stuff, here on these images, you can now see real images of devices. The first one you see here shows a device without T-star coating on it. And the second image here is a successor device with T-star on it. And you can easily see that most of the reflections are no longer visible in the image. And the remaining ones, they are reduced dramatically.